and I think that they're wonderful songs, and I would defend them against anybody.
The winds do blow. Oh, if you come to my father's house, there you may lay me down. Take away me maiden head, likewise have 50 pounds. All hail the dewy morning, though on the winds I owl. Clear away the morning dew, how sweet the winds do blow. But when she's come to her father's house, she's quickly locked him out. She says, young man, I'm a maid within, and you're a fool without. All hail the dewy morning, though on the winds.
Most of my repertoire actually were songs about women. But it did make for a very natural progression for me when the women's movement started in some way to kind of impinge on my life and my thought in the early 70s. For me to more consciously select songs because in some way they spoke to my increasing realization of how much my way of being in the world was a result of being a woman. I found myself being asked to sing in the women's movement, and I think the songs are so important that we need to be taking them outside the folk clubs.
So there's no cause for alarm.
There's really no cause for alarm.
It's clearly safe, clean and cheap. All sensible people.
In some ways, I think it's immensely healthy that I now do more than half my actual singing outside the folk song clubs, in community centres, community arts centres, and hopefully people from those audiences will then start to refilter back into the folk clubs. In fact, it started to happen. I mean, Leon was at a folk club, and they had the biggest audience they've had in years, and most of the audience were people that had seen Leon at C&D concerts and came into the folk club.
If you work yourself into a state of high emotion about the waste plutonium discharged into the ocean, you should not be upset by such unscientific chatter. You far more chance of being scratched to death by your pet cat. Analysis has shown a little radioactive matter just makes the water warmer so the fish are getting fatter.
I still think there's a place for the folk clubs if only we can grasp their importance and give a sense of occasion and a sense of commitment back. And I think the women's movement and CND now and some of the environmental movements are revitalizing the folk clubs. It's not just the politics, it's the passion, it's power got submerged under an interest in being good at it. Fine, but it doesn't actually honour the essence of the music. And for me, the people who are powerful are people who do honour that essence. And it's then that you get excitement, you know?
Picture me standing outside Sainsbury's. Me two big bags are hanging, banging round me knees. I got four sliced loaves, tomato spuds and marmalade. And all me pips are squeaking with the Tories bleeding. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze.
I never want to only sing traditional songs to traditional audiences or contemporary women's songs to women's audiences. That's what I find so exciting, the ability to move between ballad like Tam Lin and something like The Lady Bus Driver in the space of 5 minutes. And for a lot of the women in the women's movement who hadn't ever been to a folk club, they found this very strange as well. And what is this woman doing singing these medieval ballads about lords and ladies and women being killed because they were in love with the servant boy?
Blooming bus stops nearly 50 yards away and the traffic's going balmy though it's only 3:30.
I mean, it really was quite painful at times and quite difficult, although it was also a tremendous challenge. And the really, I mean, I think I probably relaxed into it much more and had some tremendous fun and repartee with some of the members of the audience as well.
It was lovely to be greeted by someone when I came in this evening with a request that I'd already planned to do.
I don't see any point in going to a folk club and have what I call a so what evening. All very competent, but there was no journey. It didn't take you up from where you were and put you down somewhere else. And it seems to me that, you know, a song can do that, a program, a whole evening, in some way should take you through a journey.
It's the supernatural ballad of Tam Lin and Lady Margaret. Lady Margaret, Lady Margaret, sewing of her seaman, she's all dressed in black. When a thought comes to her head, she'd run into the woods, pick flowers to flower her hat, me boys, pick flowers to flower her hat. So she's hoisted up her petticoat a bit above her knee, and so nimbly she's run o'er the plain. And when she's come to the merry green woods, she's pulled them branches down, down. She's pulled them branches down. And suddenly she spied a fine young man stood underneath the tree, saying, how dare you pull them branches down without the leave of me, lady, without the leave of me. She says, this little wood, it is me very own. Me father give it me, and I can pull these branches down without the leave of thee, young man, without the leave of thee. He's taken her by the lily white hand and by the grass green sleeve, and he's laid her down at the foot of a bush, and he's never once asked her leave, me boys, he's never once asked her leave. And when it was done, she has turned herself about to ask her true love's name. But she nothing heard and nothing saw, and all the woods grew dim, me boys. Yes, all the woods grew dim. There's 24 ladies all in the court, grown red as any rose, excepting the young Margaret. And green as glass she goes, me boys, yes, green as glass she goes. And out and spoke the first serving girl, she lifted her head and smiled. I think me ladies loved too long, and now she goes with child, me dears, yes, now she goes with child. And out and spoke the second serving girl, however, and alas, says she, I think I know a herb in the merry green wood that'll twine thee, babe, from thee, lady, that'll twine thee, babe, from thee. So Margaret's taken up her silver comb, made haste to comb her hair, and she's away to the merry green wood as fast as she can tear, me boys, as fast as she can tear. And she hadn't pulled a herb in that merry green wood, a herb but barely one, when by her stood young Tam Lin, saying, Margaret, leave it alone, me love. Oh, Margaret, leave it alone. How can you pull that bitter little herb, that herb that grows so grey, to take away that sweet babe's life that we got in our play, me dear, that we got in our play. Oh, tell me the truth, young Tam Lin, she says, if an earthly man ye be, I'll tell you no lies, Lady Margaret, he says, I was christened the same as thee, me love, I was christened the same as thee. But as I rode out one cold and bitter day, from off me horse I fell, and the Queen of Elfland, she took me in yonder green hill to dwell, me love, in yonder green hill to dwell. This night it is the Halloween, when the elf in court must ride, and if you would your true love win, by the old mill bridge you must bide, me dear, by the old mill bridge you must bide. And first will come the black horse, and then come by the brown, and then race by the white. But you'll hold me fast and fear me not, and I will not you affright, me dear, I will not you affright. And then they will change me all in your arms into many a beast so wild. But you'll hold me fast and fear me not. I'm the father of your child, you know. I'm the father of your child. So Margaret's taken up her silver comb, made haste to comb her hair, and she's away to the old mill bridge as fast as she can tear, me boys, as fast as she can tear. And at the dead hour of the night, she heard the harness ring, and oh, me me boys, it chilled her heart more than any mortal thing. It did more than any mortal thing. And first come by the black horse, and then come by the brown, and then race by the white. But she held it fast and feared it not, and it did not her affright, me boys. It did not her affright. The thunder rolled across the sky, and the stars, they blazed like day. And the Queen of Elfland gave a thrilling cry, oh, young Tam Lin's away, away, oh, young Tam Lin's away. And then they have changed him all in her arms to a lion that roared so wild. But she held it fast and feared it not. It was the father of her child, she knew. It was the father of her child. And then they have changed him all in her arms into a loathsome snake. But she held it fast and feared it not. It was one of God's own make, she knew. It was one of God's own make. And then they have changed him all in her arms to a red-hot bar of iron. But she held it fast and feared it not, and it did to her no harm, me boys. It did to her no harm. And the last they have changed him all in her arms was to a naked man. And she's flung her mantle over him, crying, me love, I've won, I've won. Oh, crying, me love, I've won. And out and spoke the Queen of Elfinland from the bush wherein she stood. I should have tore out your eyes, Tam Lin, and put into eyes of wood, put into eyes of wood.